And John got the Big Ben.
Got the Big Ben, their signature sandwich. So I'm going to take a bite up and see how good it is.
It's dedicated to Jimmy Stewart. There's a lot of pictures here of his movies. This is my second favorite movie, Harvey, where he has an imaginary friend that actually is a rabbit. So John got the Big Ben. How's that sandwich, John?
It's really, really good. It's got capicola, coleslaw, provolone, and French fries. It's their signature sandwich. So far, so good. It's really, really good.
And what's it called again, John?
The Big Ben, which I'm not a Steeler fan, so it's hard for me to eat it, but it tastes good.
So, John, how was the Big Ben sandwich?
Well, I thought it was really good, just like Manny Brothers. Tastes kind of the same. I put it on the same level as them, and like the atmosphere of sitting with Jimmy Stewart's stuff. But I'd totally recommend this place to anybody who comes to Indiana to come in and check it out. And sit back here in the Jimmy Stewart area and get the salsa, because the salsa is incredible. Okay, we are here in Indiana, Pennsylvania for the Wonderful Life Festival. It's about a 4 or 5 week event that kicks off tonight with parades and marshmallow roasting and hay rides and everything. And we're standing in front of the Jimmy Stewart statue. So if you want to come with us tonight and have a good time and see what all this town has to offer, let's go check it out. Let's rock and roll.
The statue was dedicated to Jimmy in 1983 on his 75th birthday. The statue portrays Jimmy in one of his characters, Mr. Smith Goes to Washington.
And also, when Jimmy was here, this statue was not here. It was a fiberglass statue. This one was not done. So if you want to see the one that was here when he came through, it is in the Jimmy Stewart Museum. And also what we're standing in front of is also the former site of Jimmy Stewart's dad's hardware store, which is now the S&T Bank. Okay, this is a famous scene from It's a Wonderful Life where George is going to lasso the moon for Mary. Pretty cool on the side of this building.
So we decided to roast marshmallows.
Yes, they did.
It actually feels pretty good standing here by the fire. It's really cold. Looks like he just burnt his finger.
Town is filling up. Back down in there, they're roasting marshmallows and selling snacks. And straight up that hill is Jimmy Stewart's home. Also, Indiana, Pennsylvania is also the Christmas tree capital of the world.
Oh, put up your computer, this is still in the field. Oh, what are you seeing? It's still in the field.
George Bailey. Okay, we're standing here at Jimmy Stewart Boulevard, directly across the street. Up those steps is Jimmy Stewart's house, right there. So let's take a walk up those steps and take a look. Okay, we are standing beside Jimmy Stewart's house on Vinegar Hill. Pretty good hike up this thing. View of downtown Indiana. Off to my right is Jimmy Stewart's house. Okay, this is Jimmy Stewart's house. Pretty nice. Nice view of the town. All right, we're in Philadelphia Street at 7th, and a few years ago the city had Rich Little do an impersonation of Jimmy Stewart on these crosswalks. So we'll push it here in a minute, and you can hear how cool it is.
This is Jimmy Stewart. North 7th Street walk sign is on to cross North 7th Street, and take your time.
Okay, we had a great time, and it's a Wonderful Life Festival, and taking in all the Jimmy Stewart sites around town. So if you like this video,
give it a thumbs up and subscribe.
So until we meet again, J&B have left Indiana, Pennsylvania. I always see my hand.
This room is dedicated to Jimmy Stewart. There's a lot of pictures here of his movies. This is my second favorite movie, Harvey, where he has an imaginary friend that actually is a rabbit. Okay.